The Chief Executive Officer, Mr. Lars Gustavsson, and the Tropical Coordinator, Dr. Allan Carlson, both from WWF Sweden, were guests at the WWF Central Africa Regional Programme Office and particularly the WWF Costal Forests Programme, Cameroon. The one-week visit ran from April 13th to 18th, 2008. At the WWF Costal Forests Programme Office in Limbe, Dr. Atanga Ekobo, coordinator of the program, presented WWF Sweden's support to WWF Costal Forest Program's activities. Then the guests visited Mount Cameroon to have a feel of the proposed Mount Cameroon National Park. Later in the day, they set off to Bangem to be part of ceremonies aimed at sensitizing stakeholders on the creation of the Bakossi National Park.
This is Bangem, chief town of Kupe Manuguba Division. It is the heartbeat of the Bakossis, one of the biggest ethnic groups in the southwest province of the Republic of Cameroon. The people have from time immemorial derived their livelihood from their forests with activities such as hunting, the collection and harvesting of non-timber forest products, logging and farming. These activities have in no small way contributed to the degradation of the mountain forests of Bakossi, Kupe and Manuguba that make up the Bakossi landscape area. It was against a backdrop of this problem that the government of Cameroon on November 28, 2007 set up the Bakossi National Park to protect what is still left of the area's rich biodiversity from further damage. The news was not well received by the Bakossi people and other groups now living within and around the national park, covering a surface area of 29,320 hectares. It is evening and we are in the secret grove of the Bangem people. This is where the spirits of the ancestors meet with the spirit of the living. The head of the Ahong Society, His Majesty Akame Peter, and other custodians of the shrine are invoking the spirits of the ancestors to let the coming of the Bakossi Park be a blessing to the land. This ceremony paves the way for the holding of a meeting of stakeholders of the Bakossi National Park on the goals and scope of the protected area. The venue was the conference hall of the Bangem Council. Besides administrative, municipal, forestry and wildlife officials, the forum brought together a cross-section of traditional rulers of Kupe Manuguba Division, custodians of the traditions and ancestral land of the Bakossi people. Welcoming participants to the forum, the mayor of Bangem, Eku Oje Simon, said national parks, wherever they are located, remain a cherished treasure to the nation as a whole and to the local population in particular. He noted that the creation of the park was a wonderful gift for which the people have every reason to rejoice. Without wanting to take the place of competent technicians of the Ministry of Forestry and Wildlife to talk about the status of the newly created national park, Eku Oje Simon invited all his people to listen attentively so as to understand the important place the national park has in government's conservation efforts.
Well, I think we have to allay their fears by saying that the 1994 forestry law has made provision for participatory management of our natural resources. And within the framework of the management plan, the Ministry of Forestry and Wildlife is going to work very closely with the population and to make sure that all the activities that will be carried out in the national park will be done in close collaboration with the communities, with the forest adjacent communities, and there is no reason for them to be afraid, because the steps that are taken in the establishment of a management plan is a participatory step, and of course everybody's interest will be taken into account, so that we don't look only at the conservation aspects, we'll look at livelihood aspects, we'll look at developmental aspects. And of course the management plan has two parts to it. It has the part that has to do with management of the resources, and of course it has a part that has to do with a business plan, and in that business plan the sources of finances are looked into, so that the interest of everybody is taken into account. So I believe that with this participatory process that has been going on since 1994, the population have no reason to be afraid. On the contrary, I think the creation of a national park comes with a lot of fall-offs, and one of the fall-offs from this could be even ecotourism, and it is believed that if that is well developed, they will have their interest in it. Beside that, there are other aspects that they could benefit from it, just the fact that the animals are there. There will be many people who will be interested in, and they will want to see it, and I think it is a legacy for the future generation. So I think from the culture of the Bakossi people, it is not going to be a new thing. They've been living with the forest, they cherish it, they know that it is part of the culture, and I believe together with them, with hands on the deck, we are going to achieve it.
Economically, the Bakossi landscape area in general and the national park in particular are also hotspots in Kupe-Maniguba division.
If you want to talk about the economic importance of the national park, in the case of Bakossi National Park, I think I see in it the perennity in the resources that will enable people to keep harvesting forever. That's the first thing we'll get there. And then the second thing will be that we will draw more international attention. You see, we will push our friends to the world. They have promised things, and I'm sure they will keep in their words. We have many challenges to take up. One of them is to improve livelihood of people. And we have started doing it around Kupe. And if you see people coming like this, it's because they've already seen us working. And I'm quite sure that what we'll start doing will trigger more development through the government participation into what we are doing. You know, MINFOF is one among many other ministries. But working with MINFOF and try to bring in Ministry of Agriculture, for instance, will enable the government to try to do more than they were doing in the area. I'm not saying that we'll do everything, but at least we'll do as far as we can go, as far as we can get means from the means from abroad. That's what I'll say here.